Spirit of the Lord is upon me, because he has anointed me to bring the good news to the poor. He has sent me to comfort the brokenhearted, and to proclaim that the captives will be released, and the prisoners will be freed. To proclaim the year of the Lord's favor, and the day of vengeance of our God.
The Lord reigns. Let the earth be glad. Let the distant shores rejoice. Clouds and thick darkness surround him. Righteousness and justice are the foundation of his throne. Fire goes before him and consumes his foes on every side. His lightning lights up the world. The earth sees and trembles. The mountains melt like wax before the Lord. Before the Lord of all the earth, the heavens proclaim his righteousness, and all peoples will see his glory.
Good afternoon, everybody. Today is a very special and interesting day. I'm going to do something different. We're not going to talk about the reason why you want to own gold and silver, as I've done in many, many other prior interviews. We're going to talk about, once you've got it, how you should handle owning actual physical gold and silver. Today on my podcast, I have a friend of mine. I think I've known Chad for 5, 6, 7 years already. And the business that he's involved in is a private vault, of which has been around for 40 years. So I'm doing this because many people reach out to me all the time asking, you know, I've got precious metals, gold, silver. Do I store it at home? What do I do? And so those of you, this is for those of you who don't have, like many people have like 401ks. Those are separate because you're going to be storing that at a private facility where someone's doing it for you. You have a third party storing it for you. So those of you who physically have taken possession of precious metals, own it personally, and want to know, you know, what's some safe ways of storing it. You know, what should I know about owning precious metals personally? Because ultimately, by you owning precious metals, you become your own bank. In other words, you don't need an intermediary, because owning gold and silver, you know, Haggai 2 verse 8, the silver and the gold are mine, saith the Lord. If you're holding God's money, you also want to be safe and wise and smart in protecting it, so nothing happens to it. With all of that said, we're going to speak with a good friend of mine, Chad. Chad is the owner of The Vault here in Orange County, Newport Beach. So I met with him personally, and I wanted him to come on the show and give us all the good, the bad, and the ugly about precious metals and storage. So welcome, Chad.
Good afternoon, Bo. How are you?
I'm great. Thank you. Thank you for being here.
Thank you for having me.
So those of you who are also wondering, you know, why we're not going to put Chad's face on, well, very simple, is because he owns a private vault worth incredible amounts of money. So we want to keep a little bit of discretion, but you later in this presentation will be able to get a hold of him personally and speak with him. And those of you who ever want to meet with him, you know, can as well too. But ultimately, we're just trying to keep, you know, a little bit of privacy here.
The approach is being, you know, better safe than sorry, really.
Yeah, I got it. So Chad, tell us a little bit about your private vault, and just in general about private vaults in general, and why somebody would want to be involved with you, or with any private vault for that matter. You know, why would we want to take our gold and silver that people say, if they possess it or own it, hold it, you know, why would we want to put it in a vault? And the difference between vaults, and also how you're different than from like a bank, for example.
Yeah. So the vault here, first thing to know is that this is a subterranean vault. It's underground. It's operated 40 plus years. I'm a corporate attorney. I've been licensed about 21, 22 years. And I located this facility in approximately 2012. It had already operated 30 years. The gentleman that owned it was 87 years old at the time. And I became a client, I rented a box, and pretty quickly started discussions about buying the vault. The reason I was enamored with the vault when I found it is that it's approximately 800 safe deposit boxes. It is a private, I call it a private bank vault, in the sense that when you walk in, it's very much like the bank vault that you would see just at your typical bank. But when you're renting your box, you're renting it from a private company. In this case, my private company. So having operated 40 years and having found this location roughly 10 years ago, I took it over and really decided, how can I make it better? And not just to be one of the private vaults in the United States, there are roughly only about 15 private vaults in the United States, but how to be the best. And number one, what I really focused in on is just referrals only. And number two, of course, having, you know, that level of security that would put my mind at ease, my family's mind at ease, as well as all of my clients. Number three, if I got a security rating high enough, would clients be able to insure their assets? And we did get that insurance or that security rating high enough very quickly. And our clients are able to insure their assets. And more importantly, they're able to store their assets, touch their assets, and have the only two keys to the safe deposit box that we have here. The reason that clients rent from private vaults, in my opinion, is they like my vault because it's operated 40 plus years. They also like that they have their own insurance policy. What's different, primarily different, about renting a safe deposit box at a bank is that, first of all, you're dealing with employees who come and go. With a vault like mine, you'll know the owner, you'll have a long-term relationship with the owner. And also with banks, you not only can't have an insurance policy on the items inside your safe deposit box at a bank, but the bank contract will specifically exclude insurance, even FDIC coverage.
One thing I want to chime in here, you know, that's actually very interesting. So in other words, you can put your gold or silver in a bank vault, but you can't insure it. That's crazy, you know, which is incredible. Whereas in a private vault, you can actually get insurance against your content, you know. So that in and of itself is huge. But this is one layer which I want to add to what you're saying. The reason people in the first place, from my understanding of after all these years of study, the reason the first place someone might want to buy gold and silver, because what is it? It's an insurance policy in and of itself against the government. So if you're going to take your precious metals and store them in the bank's vault, which they're not letting you get insurance for in the first place, and you're buying insurance against the government, because that's what it is. It's an insurance policy in case the government financially ever does something crazy. Well, look what's going on in the world, right? And so the reason why you want to have private storage is because if you buy gold and silver, you're buying it as insurance against the government. So to take your insurance and put it back in the vault where the government, you know, operates, you know, that's the definition of insanity. So the point being is, if you're going to hold it anywhere, buried in your backyard is a perfect example, versus having it in the banking institutions. But, you know, but that leads us to, you know, a private vault, because it's rather incredible level of security you offer there.
Definitely. So for those of your listeners that are thinking about storing their items at a private vault, should they be located on the East Coast, for example, they're not close enough to our vault to come and rent. They want to make sure that the vault that they're looking at is, or that they're considering, is approved by Underwriter Laboratories for security, which we are. And a vault that is approved by Underwriter Laboratories then has the ability, like we do and we have, to go out to insurance companies and say, would you like to write insurance policies on the assets that my clients have here? One of the interesting things when you bring up the word, just the broad sense of the term insurance, insuring yourself in many different ways, you're insuring yourself multiple times here, not just with an insurance policy, but in the mitigation of risk of storing items at your home or at your office, or let's say buried in your backyard. You're once again mitigating that risk by having it in a private vault, having it in a box that you have the only two keys to, then on top of it, having an insurance policy on it, and knowing that your items are stored in a vault that's UL approved for security, Underwriter Laboratories has vetted the not only the owner, but the policies and procedures of the business, as well as the vault facility itself.
And now furthermore, when you start looking at some of these assets, you know, that institutions hold for you, right, they're it's called commingled. You might want to research that term, commingled, but they take precious metals, which you believe you own, they might be co-mingled with a bunch of other people that think they own the same asset. And because you can't go check to see whether, you know, whether it's under your own lock and key, you don't know who's got what, and do you really even own it, or do other people believe they own the same precious metals that you think you own? That's the problem with how our world operates, right? It's all based on faith and confidence. That's the essence of the financial system that we work with. And what we're about to find out, those who have listened to my presentations of past, you know, the whole problem is the two words, faith and confidence. You can't trust the system because the system is what's causing all the problems.
Yeah, so following on, following on the idea of insurance with insurance with insurance, a lot of clients will, on their first phone call, say, well, can you sort of visualize, you know, give me a perception of what it's like to rent at a private vault. And I set up, when I took over the facility, again, it had been operating 30 years, but I wanted to set it up the way that I wished that it was set up when I was a client. So first and foremost, clients make their appointments through a text message or through a phone call. I would say probably 80% use the 80 to 90% use the text message method. We ask that they make the appointment the day before. And then imagine you come into a private vault room that's approximately 30 feet wide and 40 feet long with approximately 800 safe deposit boxes. You, in a very private setting, you're the only person in the vault. The person that showed you into the vault, myself or my assistant, you've known us forever, for however long you've rented in several clients' cases, more than, you know, 10 years. And then we open the safe deposit, but we assist you with opening the safe deposit box because, again, you have the only two keys. You're able to pull your assets out, take them to a private viewing room, just like in a bank, and you spend the time, whether it's organizing your stamp collection or organizing your gold collection or your silver collection or your coin collection, you can spend the time. And if you need a 2 or 3 hour appointment, you let us know. One other thing I wanted to talk about with insurance, because you asked me, Bo, how I've sought to differentiate myself from not only banks, but other private vaults. We offer by far more insurance when you rent at very reasonable prices than any other private vault. So in our, we have 12 different size safe deposit boxes. The smallest is the typical that you see at a bank, that 3-inch by 5-inch box that's 2 feet deep. And our largest on the other end of the spectrum, it's so large you could fit probably 10 sets of golf clubs in it. The smallest boxes are 3 smallest sizes. When you rent for those 3 smallest sizes, we include a $30,000 policy. And all of our medium boxes from size 4 up to 12, we include a $50,000 policy. We've done that so that a client could come in, pay a very reasonable, let's say one of our middle size boxes is $900 a year, pay a very reasonable price. And included in that $900 is a $50,000 policy that is $110 that comes right out of our end. So the idea when I took it over was not only that highest level of security, so you're mitigating the risk from storing stuff at your house, but then a personal relationship with the vault owner, somebody you're in contact with. I play golf with many of my clients. I've had breakfast, lunch, dinners with many of my clients. I know many of their families. A lot of my closest friends actually first met as clients here. So that's the kind of relationship that we foster here, is that ongoing personal business relationship. And quite honestly, you probably have a lot of questions to ask about this. We're very, very picky about who we let rent here. That's just my attorney risk management, risk mitigation brain at work since the day I took over the facility. So it's not that easy to get in here, but clients love it once they are.
This is like cool that we get to speak with someone who owns a private vault. Because, you know, so many people, you know, I've been in the gold silver community for a long time, and I get it's just the constant questions I get about, you know, how do I store it? Where do I store it? And so like, let me ask you a question, Chad. Those that do live, do people who rent from you, are they just in Orange County? Do you have people that drive a distance? Are there a lot of vaults in California? You said there's 15 roughly vaults across the United States. So are they kind of all spread out? Give us a little bit about, you know, your location and other locations of vaults around the United States that you're aware of.
Yeah, so what I like to say is that we're centrally located in Orange County. For those people that live in Southern California that know where the Orange County Airport is, we're within a half a mile of the Orange County Airport, very close to all the freeways, the 405, the 5, as well as the 73 freeway. In terms of our clientele, I've seen clientele all the way from the furthest reaches of Northern California all the way down to, you know, San Diego, out to Riverside, San Bernardino. A large base of our clients are Orange County, Los Angeles, Riverside, San Bernardino, and San Diego counties. But we do have the occasional client. And just to touch on that for a sec, when the riots and burglaries started happening, home burglaries started happening in large numbers in LA, we had quite a few clients come down from LA. And that was the first, what I refer to as the first sort of LA bump that I saw. And as those home robberies, lack of prosecutions continued to occur, more and more clients would come down from LA. Of course, those robberies spread into Orange County as well as San Diego. So I have quite a few clients, not only from Orange County, but San Diego, Riverside, and San Bernardino. I do have clients from the Phoenix, Scottsdale area. There, as you know, there are quite a few gold and silver dealers in the Phoenix, Scottsdale area. So I'll have clients that will say, hey, you know, would you mind doing a Saturday appointment? Our typical hours are Monday through Friday, 9 to 5. But I'll do the occasional Saturday appointment for a client. Let's say they're coming from Phoenix or Scottsdale and they want to rent a safe deposit box. I have quite a few clients that come from Las Vegas as well. They might have a home here in Southern California as well as a home in Las Vegas. Lake Tahoe clients as well. My suggestion for anybody, let's say in any of those states, maybe you live in Colorado or maybe you live in Texas, maybe you live east of the Mississippi. When you research a vault, you, as I said earlier, you want to make sure that they're UL approved. I think that you should ask them if they screen their clients. Do they know who their clients are? Are they careful about who they rent to? And I also think that insurance is going to be a big one, and how long they've been in business. And just to be more specific, for those folks that live, let's say, close to Texas, there is a vault there called Freedom Vault. I can't personally recommend them because I haven't rented a vault there, but I can tell you that the insurance company that writes the policies for my clients here at the vault in Newport Beach also writes policies for clients at Freedom Vault in Texas, as well as there's another vault in Virginia that's called Commonwealth Vault, and the same insurance company writes policies there for clients who store their assets there. And then there's another one called, I think it's fairly new, but it's called Guardian Vault in Washington State. Again, have never stepped into these vaults privately, but just knowing that the insurance company that I utilize also writes policies for those clients in those safe deposit box vaults, that tells me a lot that they have the correct policies and procedures and that they have that high level of security that we have here.
I also wanted to add, for those of you listening to this podcast but do not live in the United States, a friend of mine, Egon von Greyer, has a private vault actually within the Swiss Alps. It's a highly secure facility. So if you're looking into private storage and you live in Europe, I will include his links below to his private storage facility in the Alps. In the description box, we'll include the links to the other vaults as well, too, including your vault as well, Chad, here in California, Southern California. So people, if they want to find you, they'll be able to find you easily. I just wanted to take some time to let the viewers know it's critically important to be able to be smart and wise and protect your assets as well, too, because our world's changing. You know, we see our world changing in front of our eyes. And, you know, like you stated, with the things that are going on in Los Angeles and how you see a sudden jump in people renting boxes at your facility, things are drastically changing and will continue to change, you know, in the years ahead. So being smart and being wise to protect your assets, I just thought this would be a great opportunity, since I know you, Chad, to, you know, to put you out here and let people, you know, learn a little bit about private vaults and the benefits of them. So if people want to reach out to you, Chad, what's the best way for them to find you or reach out to you?
The best way is just to go to our website, which is privatesafedepositbox.com. You'll see the phone number there. When you call the number, that is a 24/7 number that's operated by, or that's run by our operators. The call will be screened. I will listen to it before I return any phone calls. That's the first bit of our screening, but that phone number is 949-660-9222. Again, 949-660-9222. And to learn more about the business, you could go to our website at privatesafedepositbox.com.
Okay. Any messages you want them to leave or anything special that would help you screen them?
Absolutely. So one of the directions that I've given our operators is to ask the referral source. Obviously, a referral source is the best from a security perspective for us. So when they ask referral source, the typical person says, oh, my friend who rents there, his name or her name is this, has referred me. Those are the ones that I look to and immediately return those calls. And I'll do the same if your clients and members are calling and saying that they were referred by Gold 2020 Forecast. I also have clients who say that they found me online, whether it's Yelp or Google reviews, because we have a lot of very positive Yelp and Google reviews. So when the operator asks, please say Gold 2020 Forecast. And then that way I know exactly these calls will all be returned within, if not 3 or 4 hours, certainly 24 hours.
Cool. That's great. Appreciate it. Those of you who live in Southern California, if you're interested in hooking up with Chad and learning more about what he offers, reach out to him. Those of you who live in different states, again, we will definitely link those other references that Chad referenced. So people live in different parts of the country, of the United States, check out those facilities. But again, I appreciate you being here, Chad. I just wanted my viewers to really learn about the benefits of safe storage and how incredibly important it is to be in control of your own personal finances. And gold and silver offer that. There's no middleman, there's no third party risk by owning gold and silver. So the only other thing is if you have large amounts of it, you might want to store it somewhere safely, and safe deposit boxes is a great place to start. So Chad, any closing words that you want to add?
Well, I just want to personally thank you. Through the years, eight plus years of me owning and operating this facility, I've had several of your members slash clients that have come in and said that through a personal conversation with you that you had recommended coming in. And first of all, I want to thank you for that. I want to thank you for the invitation today. And I really look forward to receiving any phone calls from your members.
All right, Chad, I appreciate you. God bless you, your family, and thank you for being here. God bless.
Thank you, Bob. God bless.